I'm going to go back and look at the video and look at you guys individually, the percussion part. But if you did, go ahead and do it individually. I'll give you some extra credit for it because I know that's kind of a pain that you did it. Now we're not making everybody do it that way.
Thank you.
fourth one has the diddle on the fourth note, so the accent goes on the first one.
Thank you.
you've already gotten this from me, but I don't know that everybody has. We're going to go over flandrags. We're going to go over cheeses. We're going to go over cheese pies. And if we have time, I think the last one that I'm going to require you guys to learn this year is a single version of accent drags. So when we did the accent drag, so a single version of that would look like this. And that's probably about as far as I will get. I don't know, I might add this one. We're basically making the roll and put accents in different places. It's a good extra. So we'll probably learn this more, and that'll be it for this year. The rest of the stuff will be your music for band and your solo content and stuff. Okay, so flandrags. In 16 minutes, your first pass is this. Flam tap is just this. You guys are already doing this. practice this one.
Watching them, maybe something good.
basically what I did is I played the exercise that I taught you. You know, it's four of everything, and then I played it as two of everything, and then I played it as one of everything, and then I took the check pattern out altogether and played each pattern twice. So like that twice, and then I played it all once. So the point of teaching you all this stuff isn't so much that I want you to learn all these crazy exercises as much as I want to develop your hands so that when you start getting into more advanced material with your hands, you'll be prepared for it. So you'll start dealing with this when you have your snare solos, for instance, or timpani solos, or things on tom-toms. And even though mallet instruments are a little different than drumming instruments, a lot of it does cross over. Because you're going to have to be doing these different sticking patterns when you play these notes around the keyboards. So all this stuff's applicable. It's supposed to help develop your hands. So what you guys get a lot here in this school is you learn how to read music really well. You get to do a lot of really cool ensembles and solos. But sometimes it's hard to keep up with the technical side of what we do. What we do is very different than what the other instruments do in the band. All right, guys. I think that's about it. Thank you, and I'll see you guys next week. Okay, practice the new stuff I showed you.